current Wall Street Journal article that just came out, over 100 economists made a prediction in March of 2023 that said the market was going to do a year-over-year depreciation of about 2.2%. Well, this is what they're doing with those predictions at this point. So the Wall Street Journal article talks quite a few things about, you know, what's going on in the market right now on a national level, but we're also going to be talking a little bit more about what's going on a more local Washington, D.C. metro area level compared to national. So when we look at markets, what we see in the news all the time is really what's going on typically nationally. And that could be a market like Austin, Texas, which had massive appreciation and market activity over the past several years, and now it's coming back down into realistic numbers. Other parts of the country, Seattle, Chicago, Florida, they all operate a little bit differently. So we need to take in consideration what's happening in our specific market, our type of properties, and what we're actually selling on a regular basis. So the article is basically making note that the home prices aren't as falling as they expected to, or the fall has been less dramatic than they expected, and really what's kind of making that happen. So what we're doing is analyzing median sale prices nationally and locally, but the Wall Street Journal article really helps kind of pinpoint, you know, what's going on. With the national market the way it is right now, they're saying it's going to be shorter, softer landing than what we expected. I have some charts here that we're going to go over in just a moment. What we're seeing is with the interest rates where they are currently, which is more of a normalized interest rate, and right now we're looking high sixes, low sevens, something along those lines. If we look historically, those were normal interest rates. When we had COVID and we saw 2%, 3%, and 4% interest rates, that was basically, the economy trying to get back going. We had to give free money away. People were buying. And a lot of those people who have 2% and 3% interest rates are not moving. They're not moving because if they go from a 2% or 3% interest rate to a 6% or 7%, their home costs and things like that a lot more. So what we're seeing is people who need to move are still moving. People who don't need to move are not just making random choices and making that happen. So what that means is people are staying in their homes longer. There's less inventory, which means there's less transactions. So while we have less transactions, it's not specifically saying that the median value of properties is going down or anything like that because of the inventory. So it's kind of a balanced system right now, especially in the Washington, D.C. metro area where we're looking at. So I'm going to flip over to a chart here. All right. So this is part of the Wall Street Journal article that came out first or second week of September 2023. And what it's showing is the historical numbers of year-over-year appreciation. So where we're seeing this huge drop, that's not a drop in property values until we get to this point right here. What it is a year-over-year appreciation. So what we saw over all of these years here were kind of a normal, let's say between, on average, 5% or 6% property appreciation. This year, in 2013, we saw pretty good national appreciation. And then, in 2011, from 10 to 11, we saw a slight bit of depreciation of median property values. With that said, COVID really brought a lot of transactions. As we can see, we had a year over year of May 2021, 25% median price appreciation, which is huge. What that was going on was a lot of people were taking a look at their properties that they were living in pre-COVID and saying, okay, how does this fit our needs now? And a lot of people were like, okay, I don't want to be in the inner cities. I want to be in the suburbs because I need more space for multiple home offices, kind of those type of things. So a lot of people were moving around for that aspect. A lot of people were moving out of certain areas to other parts of the country. So there were a lot more transactions, plus the low interest rates of 2% or 3%, which I don't think we're ever going to see again. But those interest rates help people decide to go ahead and move as well. So we saw massive a number of transactions during that time period, and a lot of multiple offers and appreciation. So that is a national chart that we kind of look at, and that's part of this article. But what's more important is what's actually happening in the Washington, D.C. metro area. So if we, so this is actual median sale price in the Washington, D.C. metro area. So it covers kind of the inner suburbs of D.C., Maryland, and Virginia, that really we consider the metro area. And what we've seen, this chart goes back to 2013, where, you know, property median sales were about, you know, $400,000. And every single year, we just keep on going up and up and up. And we see peaks around June and July, May, June, and July of every year, which is what we're seeing on each one of these here, the little peaks and valleys of actual sale prices. So I think that's a pretty interesting chart there that kind of shows year over year, we continually see steady numbers going up over and over again. Now, you know, one thing we also look at is year over year change. So this chart here is super important because what it represents is as we kind of move forward, we're only seeing this little blip here of depreciation, which was around 2016, January, and then this little blip more recently when people, you know, had turned on the brakes regarding purchasing, but now they're understanding that it is time to buy because properties are going to continue to appreciate most likely and move forward. And, you know, like the article said, it's not going to be nearly as deep or lengthy of any type of depreciation of property values. So this shows year over year appreciation. And again, as we saw nationally in 2020 and 2021, we saw 15% and about 17% year over year appreciation. So that's, you know, pretty telling of what was happening during COVID, what happened after COVID with slightly higher interest rates or the higher interest rates. And now people are starting to pull back and say, okay, last month, if we look at this, it was a 4.8% year over year appreciation. So we're getting back into that normal, kind of normal market conditions. Now, Washington, D.C. is, you know, I work with a lot of sellers. Washington, D.C. is very known for being pretty transient. A lot of people are moving in and out. A lot of corporate jobs move people in and out. We do also have the federal government, which provides massive stability typically in really steady, continuous transactions, and transactions create a steady market because we have the history of what's going on. So as I mentioned, the Economist in March of 2023 said we're going to see about a 2% property depreciation on an annual basis moving forward for the foreseeable future. Well, in August, those same 100 economists were resurveyed, and now they're saying, oh, just kidding, we're looking at a 3.3% appreciation. So, you know, they're thinking that they made a mistake at the beginning of this year saying we're going to see property drop, and we're not, especially in the local DC market. So when we're talking with our buyers and sellers about what's going on, we talk about specifically what's going on, where they're looking to purchase, where they're looking to sell, what buyers and sellers are thinking, and really more of an educational point of what we're seeing nationally versus what we're seeing locally. We are in this market every single day. We know what's going on. If you have questions, let us know. That's what we're here for. Again, my name is Evan Johnson with Wardman Residential at Compass. We're here for you.